Waveport. A new Kickstarter recently reached out to me with their new waterproof headphones and asked if I wanted to test them out. Naturally, I said yes. Testing electronics is my specialty. These headphones are Bluetooth, but also have 8 GB of internal memory, so they can function as a normal MP3 player without needing a phone to control them. The packaging is pretty solid. Little magnets hold the flap in place, and then foam holds the headphones and all of the earbuds. These earbuds are important, and I'll come back to them later. A soft rubber-coated wire wraps around your head and over your ears to keep the headphones in place. The headphones have a sealed body and supposedly a coated PCB board, but we'll check on that later. Inside the mesh bag comes the micro USB charging cable that plugs into the dock and an extra batch of headphone buds. Now, these are extremely important if you plan on using these headphones underwater. As we know, speakers use air to produce sound. Without air, there's no way for the speaker vibrations to reach your ear. So this extra set of earbuds traps a little pocket of air between your ear and the headphone speaker, allowing you to hear underwater. Now, this does quiet the sound ever so slightly. I had to turn my headphones up all the way, but it does still work. If you try and wear the regular earbuds with the hole, your headphones will still be waterproof, it just doesn't have air to transfer the sound and you won't be able to hear anything at all. The air pocket earbuds are extremely important. The micro USB charging cable plugs into the charging dock, and then the little pins on the dock match up with the contact points on the left headphone to charge. This is part of the waterproof feature. There is an LED indicator on the dock that indicates when the headphones are fully charged, and that takes about 2 hours or so. I have tried quite a few wireless headphones in the past. When comparing the Waveports to some of the big boys, like the Powerbeats, the Beats have a similar behind-the-ear design and weigh about the same, but the behind-the-head wire design of the Waveports make it slightly more comfortable and get the earbuds a bit deeper into your ear. And since your ear is sealed off, the base of the Waveports comes through a lot more than the base on the Beats. The Under Armour JBL headphones are another favorite of mine. They also seal off your ear entirely, but since the JBLs do not have any over-the-ear hooks, they don't stay in quite as well during running or lifting. Battery life and Bluetooth connectivity distance are pretty much the same across all of the headphones. I've been wearing the headphones around for the last few days, getting a feel for the sound. When not in use, they'll sit secure on my neck and don't fall out when I'm benching or lifting weights, like the JBL Under Armours do. And the behind-the-neck wire gently keeps things snug, unlike the long loose ribbon on the Beats that catches and tugs at my ears every time I turn my head. And most importantly, they do not bounce out when I am running. I spend more time out of the water than in it, so the daily usability factor of the headphones is more important than the waterproof feature for me. But since the whole point of the waterproof headphones is the waterproof part, let's test them out in some water. Now, Waveport claims that the headphones are IPX7, which means that they can be underwater for 30 minutes at a depth of 1 meter. I'm not the best at following rules, so I took off my arm floaties and swam to the deep end of the pool. Bluetooth does not work underwater, so Spotify or Pandora is out of the question. But since the headphones have 8 GB of internal memory, my phone does not need to be nearby. At this point, I do have the water buds attached, the ones with a little air pocket inside, so the sound is a little bit quieter than normal, but definitely still audible. The headphones stayed on well enough for the general floating and swimming around, but fell off if I ever pushed away from the wall. I imagine wearing one of the little rubber hair caps would help keep them in place, but I'm fresh out of hair caps at the moment. These headphones would work great in the shower or for a water aerobics class, but if they fall off, they will sink to the bottom of the pool. Now, one of my qualms with the water-resistant Galaxy S7 is that the motherboard was not coated with a hydrophobic spray, and therefore missing an important layer of protection. Waveport didn't exactly give me permission to take these apart, but here we go. Remember, I'm only doing this as a demonstration and to verify advertising like I always do. If you open these headphones at all, you will lose any waterproof capabilities and warranty and all of that good stuff. Once the speaker cap is off, we can see the shiny circuit board and speaker wires and the internal memory card. If I drop any water on the components, it will immediately run off the board, leaving it completely dry, unlike on the Galaxy S7 where the water would cling to the uncoated circuit board and not run off. So this board is indeed coated with the hydrophobic spray, and with that, you are definitely safe to use them in the rain, the pool, the shower, or anywhere else that they might get wet. Pretty impressive. Now, are these going to be my favorite headphones ever? Time will tell. I usually decide which headphones to wear as I'm walking out the door to the gym. I do know that these headphones will hold their own against headphones that are 4 times the price. So thank you, Waveport, for sending these out to me, and I will leave all of the related Kickstarter and product info down in the video description if you are interested in checking them out or curious and want more information. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you around.